Blood Talk fans. Today, we are back for another episode in Transfusion Medicine, or Blood Bank. We will start with foundations of Blood Bank, the ABO blood groups. In this video, I will give you an ABO blood group overview, including genetics and Punnett square. I will include timestamp in the description box down below, so you can refer to that as well if there's any topic that you are particularly interested in. There are a lot to cover today. Without further ado, let us all click that like button, share, subscribe, and don't forget to click the notification bell. ABO blood group is the single most important blood group in transfusions and organ transplant. The ABO antibodies are naturally occurring, which means our body make anti-A and anti-B or both naturally without having to be exposed to transfusions or pregnancy before. Because of these reasons, transfused patients with incompatible ABO blood types may cause immediate loss of donor red blood cells, which can be referred to as transfusion reactions. Transfusion reactions can lead to renal failure and death. There are different types of transfusion reactions, such as intravascular hemolysis, extravascular hemolysis, hemolytic disease of fetus and newborn, and there's many more. If you want to know more about transfusion reaction, please let me know in the comment sections. Now let's get back to ABO blood group systems. Let's talk about genetics. Genetics and inheritance of ABO blood groups. We inherit one ABO gene from each parent. It is located on chromosome 9. Chromosome 9 from mother and father make up the offspring blood type. Each of the chromosomes carry A, B, or O, while O is considered as amorphous because O alleles encode for non-functional enzyme. O group phenotype is an autosomal recessive trait, which means that the offspring has to inherit it from both parents to express the trait. The ABO genes are codominant and follow the Mendelian genetics. We can predict the baby genotype and phenotype using the Punnett square. If we know the parent's blood type, we can try to see what combinations are the genotype and blood type that the baby could have. If both parents have group A blood, for an individual to express A blood type, the individual can either have AA or AO genotype. We can predict the baby genotype and phenotype using Punnett square. You can see that the baby will have phenotype A, but there are two possibilities for the genotype, which are either AA or AO. I will give you another example. One parent's blood type is AB and another parent's is A with the genotype of AO. Now your offspring can have one of the three blood types: A, AB, or B. This also can be used backward, which means if you know the baby blood type, we can try to find out the parent genotype. The ABO genes are not coded for productions of ABO antigen directly. They code for enzyme glycosyl transferase. This enzyme added sugar to the precursor, which then expressed as A or B antigens on the surface of red blood cells. Therefore, ABO antigens are not protein antigen. They are small carbohydrate epitopes on glycoproteins or glycolipids. The ABO expressions is also regulated and influenced by another gene, the H gene. The H gene located on chromosome 19. The H gene is coded for H antigen, which is a precursor structure for A and B antigen. Without H antigen, no A or B antigen can express regardless of ABO genotype. This gives rise to Bombay phenotype. Bombay is a very rare condition, but it is very interesting phenomenon. I will talk about Bombay blood type in another video. Here is a table showing glycosyl transferase and the sugar for each antigen. Notice that there are no enzyme for O antigen because the O antigen come from the lack of expressions of both A and B genes. Take a moment to absorb this if you do not fully understand this table right now, it is okay. I just want to show you the genes, the enzyme, and the correlate antigen for each gene. We will talk about it more in just a moment. How does the HA and B gene interact with each other to form A and B antigen? Each gene coded for a production of enzyme alpha-2L-fructosyltransferase that transfers sugar L-fructose to an oligosaccharide chain on the galactose terminal. Once that happens, the sugar becomes H antigen. The H antigen is a precursor or base for the A and B antigen. Next, the A genes. In people with A gene, these people are able to make enzymes called alpha-3N acetylgalactoamine transferase, which transfer N acetyl-D galactosamine at alpha-1-3 linkage to the subterminal galactose of the H antigen. This attachment changed the H antigen to an A, and now the individual will refer to as having an A blood group. In the case of people with group B blood type, the people have B genes. The people are able to make an enzyme called alpha-3-D galactose transferase, which transfer D galactose at alpha-1-3 linkage to the subterminal galactose of the H antigen. Once that happens, the H antigen gets converted to B antigen. For individuals with blood type AB, both A and B antigens are produced. How about people with group O blood type? Refer back to the table I showed you earlier. You will see that there are no enzymes responsible for transferring O sugar to the H antigen and convert H antigen to O antigen like group A and B. That is because the O gene is an amorphous which does not code for any enzyme. So for people with O genes, the antigen on the red blood cell surface is H antigen. Side note, in most people, the ABO antigens can be found on the surface of red blood cells and in secretions. However, the antigen structure is different. The structure on the red blood cells is a type 2 chain, but the structure in the secretion is type 1 chain. The difference between type 1 and type 2 chain is where the galactose attached to the N-acetylglucosamine. Type 1 chain is when the galactose attached at beta-1-3 linkage, whereas the type 2 chain is when the galactose attached at beta-1-4 linkage. Just remember, odd number go with odd number. Type 1, beta-1-3 linkage, secretion. Type 2 chained, 2 even number, 4 even number, type 2 chained, beta-1-4 linkage on the surface of red blood cells. Let's put all the bits and pieces of information together. Here's the type 1 chain with H sugar and with the A or B sugar added onto it. And here is type 2 chain with H sugar and with the A or B sugar added onto it. Here is a summary table for ABO phenotype and genotype. Since ABO is naturally occurring antibody, our bodies produce antibody for antigen that we do not have. That means a person with O blood type will naturally produce anti-A, anti-B, and anti-A, B. A person with A blood type will naturally produce anti-B. A person with B blood type will naturally produce anti-A. A person with AB blood type does not have anti-A, anti-B, and anti-A, B because the individual has all the antigens expressed on the red blood cell surface. If you look at the possible genotype, the ABO genes are codominant genes, so a person would have to get O genes from both parents to express O type. The A and B genes are the dominant genes, which can express when inherited as homozygous or heterozygous gene. That is it for today's episode on ABO blood group systems. I know it's a lot of information, but you can come back to it as many times as you like. Thank you for staying with me until the end. What do you want to know next? Do you want to know more about blood bank, chemistry, or microbiology? If you have any burning question, please feel free to leave me a comment down below. Lastly, if you have not done so, please like, share, subscribe, and click that notification bell. I will see you in the next episode of Blood Talk. Happy learning, my fellow blood bankers. As always, remember, your blood tells you the story of your health. Thanks for watching. Bye!